All right, guys, here's something a little bit different. A little Nissan Haltech ECU deal, E85. It's got a turbocharger kit built by the customer, actually a friend of the customer's, whatever, another customer of mine. Anyway, I don't know much about the turbo setup, but yeah, it's gonna make some decent numbers, I think, so check it out. So here's this 350Z. As I said, it's a Haltech car. I know they just went through the bottom end in this thing, but I don't know what's all in it. I'm sorry for my lack of knowledge on this thing. I am just a tuner, obviously, but yeah, I've got a different intake manifold on it, front mount intercooler. It's got a mid-mount turbo kit on it, I believe. But yeah, it's a neat deal. Haltech ECU thing, like I said, it's got a platinum pro plugins in it. He does have an IC7 dash set up right there, so that's pretty neat. But we've had this car here before, and the block had a external coolant crack in it, so that's why he had just gone through the bottom end and brought it back to just dial in some drivability stuff and get the full throttle things dialed in yet too. So I'm going to dive into this and see what we can make with it. I don't really know, I don't really know much about the combination or what to expect here, so we'll see what happens. Horsepower, 531 foot-pounds of torque. I want to show you the curve here and kind of explain to you what's going on. So you see the torque hit and the torque fall, which ends up being the power curve ends up being really flat, right? It appears I hit the limiter at the end of the hit. But yeah, so the reason this is happening is up here it's about 19-20 pounds of boost, and up here it's 14. So this has got a Greddy Profex boost control on it with a 4-port solenoid. He does have a 14-pound gate spring in it, but the Greddy doesn't allow me to increase duty cycle with RPM. It's just a straight duty cycle. So if I could flatten the boost curve out, it'd make a good number. His goal, I think, is mid-600s. We also are out of injector. It's got a set of thousands in it on E85. We are 95-96% injector duty at 7,000 currently. So gonna have to do some stuff with the boost controller. I'd like to run that through the Haltech and get a set of 1200s or larger injectors in this thing on E85, and then we'll really crank it up and see what we can make with it. But all in all, 570 the tire, 530 foot-pounds of torque. I think it's gonna be a riot to drive, no doubt. But yeah, that's it for this thing. I got a couple more little drivability things to touch up, just make sure cold starts okay and that kind of thing, and gonna send this one down the road and work on the next project.